Welcome to Police Quest 1. I'm your host, Lostwolfe. This is episode 7, and we are about to drive right back to the police station. We just made a bust with a guy who was evidently carrying drugs in a car, and we basically need to go back and report that. Maybe we'll get something new to do. Get into our car and close the door. And okay, drive. And of course, because we're about to drive on the road, I'm just going to take the precaution of saving. I hope everyone's had a good week, by the by. Again, mine's been sort of fairly restful. I haven't really been doing much. Doing my little bit of work that I have to do at the moment. Otherwise, I'm just sort of relaxing and playing these style games and that kind of thing. There isn't a lot to tell with my life, because essentially all I do is I play video games and I read books and listen to music and watch movies. Oh, speaking of that, a couple of weeks ago I said to you if you saw there was a certain guy, and if he ever came your way you should go see him. Well, I'm going to recommend a movie to you if you're into science fiction at all. Then go see Oblivion. Why am I so lost? I should know where the police station is by now. This bodes badly for this episode. Whoa, dude. I am so lost. Okay. Wait. Now. Could have sworn that the police station was there, but evidently I'm wrong. Why am I wrong? This does not bode particularly well for this episode. Wait, what? What? This is not a good way to start this episode at all. Okay, so I'm going to drive around for a bit and see if I can find the police station. And while I do, so I was telling you about this movie, Oblivion. It's a pretty good movie. It's a Tom Hanks movie. And Tom Hanks? Tom Cruise. And it's a pretty good, interesting science fiction movie. And if you're into that at all, you should go see it. It looks like Laura's waiting for you. You wonder what's up. Question, have I got my gun? Yes, I do. Okay, because the next bit requires a gun, pretty much. Okay, so Laura gets into the car. Sonny, one of my informants just told me of a drug deal that is going down soon in Luton City Park, says Laura, getting into your car. Luton and Morgan wants us to go and stake it out and see what we can do. Okay, sounds good. Drive, derv. Well, cowboy, let's roll. And I'm going to save, because we all know about getting out of the police station and how tricky that is. So in this movie, which is quite interesting, Tom Cruise basically gets tasked with protecting the water after a bunch of people, bad guys, aliens basically, come in and they're attacking the Earth. And how it works out is that the humans win the war and then they go off and they colonize another planet. But along the way, the moon gets wrecked, so there is no... The ecology is kind of screwed, and the little water that there is on the planet has to kind of be controlled in a way that the people, I think it's on Saturn, can get water, and that's kind of where the movie takes off. And that's about as much as I can tell you. If I tell you any more, then it would completely ruin the movie. But it's very interesting. I quite liked it. There are not a lot of actors in it, but the acting that does happen in it is pretty interesting. So, if you haven't seen that, go see it. Talk to Laura. Laura says, "Okay, Sonny, I'll move the car out of sight and monitor you for backup." Sounds good. Open door. Get out of car. Close door. Okay, so we're gonna... This is probably one of my favorite scenes. Well, not what we're gonna do now, but this is one of my favorite kind of AGI paintings. What's the matter? Let's get the show on the road. So, we're gonna go hide ourselves over here where no one can see it. See us. You conceal yourself in the bushes, but with a clear view of the table. I'm gonna turn the noise off. Okay, so now we're in drug bust mode, and basically what we have to do is we have to see what these people do before we can arrest them, because obviously you can't arrest them before you do anything, before they do anything, because they're innocent otherwise. So we're just gonna see what's up. Maybe it's not a drug thing at all. Maybe someone somewhere got something wrong. Okay. Radio. Your key extender and notify Detective Watts that you're in a concealed position. She responds to your transmission. 10-4. We'll maintain radio silence until I hear from you. Load your gun. You rip out the speed loader and load your weapon. Draw. Gun. Right. Now we're just going to patiently wait and see what happens. This is one of those things, again, where you just have to wait and see what happens, because the game is programmed on its own internal kind of clock, and until all the participants in this jolly little crime show up, or potential crime show up, you can't do anything. It's very... I like it, because it's true to life. This is kind of how a stakeout would work. I don't like it, because... it's the sort of thing that programming could have taken care of. They could have, the minute you drew your gun, the people could have come out and, you know, had their little conversation, and we could have gotten on along with it. So yeah, we have one dude, and he looks pretty nervous. He's looking around and all that kind of thing. You quietly watch a man enter the picnic area. He cautiously nears the picnic table. He's got his head spinning around a bit. He's not real happy with the situation. Let's see what else develops. It seems like he's kind of waiting for someone else, and that person is someone he's worried about, because he's furtively checking everywhere. Is his other buddy gonna show? Ah, there we go. He does indeed. Another figure carefully approaches the picnic table. Could it be the drug contact? Maybe. He heads on over. Psst, Vic, were you followed? No way, man, it's cool. I got the stuff. Did you bring the cash? Wow, that's terrible dialogue. Oh, goodness. Yeah, right here. Why one suspect hands what looks to be an envelope to the other suspect. The second suspect returns a small plastic bag containing a white substance. Hey, butt breath, this ain't enough. Where's the rest? Radio. You quietly radio Laura. I'm moving in. You hook up anybody trying to take football. That wasn't really quiet, was it? Oh well. Halt. As they argue, you realize the pusher is there, dissatisfied with the contents of the envelope. Halt. Halt, you shot. Police officer. Jiggers! The fuzz! Also, bad dialogue. Good lord, shouts the pusher. I'm out of here! And he runs off. Don't shoot, officer, shouts the young man. I give up! Okay, no problem. Sounds good. Okay, so, let's, hands up. No? You've got him under control, you just cuff him. Okay, that sounds good. Right, so, holster, and cuff man. You cuff one trembling suspect. Obviously, we need to read him his rights so that he knows what's going on. Carefully admonish your suspect of his Miranda rights. You have the right to remain silent. What you say may be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be appointed to represent you before questioning, if you wish. Okay, so let's search the man. The search reveals nothing except his school identification card, so he's very young, and a small bag containing a white powdery substance that you watched him get from the pusher. Look, ID card. The Jefferson High School student identification card in the name of Victor Sims matches the general description of your suspect. Look at the drugs. The contents of the bag appear to be cocaine, right? Let's question him. Perhaps he knows something more than just the guy who sold him the drugs. Sims is reluctant but cooperative. You learn he has been selling drugs to kids in the Jefferson High School, including Officer Cobb's daughter, Kathy. Does he know anything more? I used to buy from a guy named Jose Martinez, but then Martinez introduced me to the guy Colby Sims. Colby Sims says, I haven't seen Martinez since. So the other guy's name is Colby. Aha, Colby. All right. Follow me. You follow Sims to the patrol car. Laura asks, what took you so long, Hot Rod? I picked up this loose cannon, or loose end, trying to take football on you. Well, we were questioning the dude and all sorts of stuff. You mumble under your breath, yeah, sure, Laura. You probably just grabbed the first white male you could find. Oh, that is terrible. Oh, goodness. Okay, well, that sort of sorts that out. I'm going to make a couple assumptions here. Laura's a police officer. She probably read the guy's rights. She probably searched him. She probably cuffed him. But we need to know what he knows about this whole drug bust. So, question Colby. Colby refuses to answer any questions. Really? And question him again. After persistent questioning of Colby, you discover he buys his drugs from Leroy Pearson. We know this guy. That would be our guy who had bail warrant. And I don't remember his name. I just remember Pearson, the nipple guy. He He says Liu's telephone number is 555-6537. He also asks that his cooperation be noted for consideration by the court. Cooperation, my butt. He ran away. Closed door, that's not very cooperative at all. Lord comments, Lieutenant Morgan will be really happy with this bust. Open the door. Get in the car. And drive, derv. Alright, let's take these guys to jail. And then we shall see what we can see. Okay, the jail is down here. And of course I have to go through red robots and all that stuff. Please don't be turning, thank you. That always scares me. You're on the road and you're waiting for people and you're not sure if they're going to turn and hit you with their car. Because of course it's a police quest and erratic driving is part of the plan. Ah! Of course. Right. I tell you what, I'm going to meet you at the jail because that's like one failure too many for me today. So I shall meet you at the jail, and when I do, then we shall continue from there. And so we're at the jail. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to park car. No, really? Open door. Get out of car. Open door. Let's book these guys. Lawyer says, get the door, Sonny. I'll keep an eye on these guys. These boys. Open locker. Put gun. Locker. Okay. Locker. And press the buzzer. You push the buzzer. The jailer releases the electronic lock. And everyone goes inside. Slam dunk Donnie yells through the fence. Hey, baby, you boys play basketball? Maybe they might. I don't know. It kind of depends on if we can keep them there. Sonny, says Laura, I'll wait here while you complete the booking. The jailer greets you with a friendly, well, well, old Barnes is loose again. The jailer says, this is certainly a fine-looking group you got this time, Sonny. Yeah, it is. Book them. What are you charging these dudes with? Asks the jailer. Drugs. Okay, drugs will be, the jailer says. Well, fill out a booking slip and give me his property. Fill out slip. Really? You remove the inventory and deliver the prisoner's personal property to the jailer, along with the booking slip. The jailer says, okay, Sonny, remove their cuffs and put the little pushers into cell number one. Notice something now. The software pirate is gone. You remove the cuffs and place them in your handcuff case. I'm gonna sue you for making them cuffs so tight. Flatfoot threatens your prisoner. Oh, we've been called worse throughout the game. Flatfoot isn't too bad. I think you boys know where to go, you tell them. Right. Up yours, Stick Tracy. You'll never make this stick. Hey, Bonds, yells Laura. I'll wait for you in the car. Okay. Sounds good. Right. Okay, get gun. Close locker. And let's head off to the police station to report to Lieutenant Morgan. Looks like you'll be a valued addition to narcotics, Bonds, says Laura. Close door. One day, fasten seatbelt will save me. I promise. It just, today is probably not going to be that day. Alright. Oh, you may have noticed that I've pushed the speed up a tiny notch so that I could get to places faster. Which is, considering all my driving mishaps, maybe not the best idea. Okay. Laura says, Sonny, I'll go write up this arrest. I'll bet Jack is over at the Blue Room, says Laura. Why don't you go tell him we nailed the rat who was dealing dope at Jefferson High? Sounds like a good plan. Drive. So let's go do that. Really? Really? Okay. Right now, I have to remember where the Blue Room is. I think it's one screen over. Oh, goodness. Cars and driving and cars and driving and death. Ah! That was basically too close for comfort. Okay. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go to the Blue Room quickly, and that's about all we'll do for an episode. We'll call it an episode there. Close the door, and off we go into the Blue Room. You enter the Blue Room and see Jack seated at a table. He appears to be quite intoxicated. Alright, sit. Talk to Jack. Trying to cheer Jack up, you tell him about the Victor Sims arrest and how he was responsible for selling dope at the high school. Sonny, I really do appreciate you nailing that filthy scumbag pusher, but I'm afraid it might be too late. Why? My daughter Kathy is in the intensive care ward over at Lytton General Hospital, he explains. She's in a coma from a drug overdose. There's nothing I can do. Really? Oh, Sonny, there's nothing anyone can do. Really? If the doctor's there and they're looking after her, maybe she'll get better. Who knows? Always look on the bright side of life. The bartender says, For your information, Sonny, I have a cab on the way for Jack. That's good. I sure would love to stretch the neck of that sorry dope-pushing scumsucker that hurt my little girl. All these people going through all of these voices. I don't know how to be consistent. I'd love to, but I can't. The cab driver shouts out, Hey, who called for the taxi? That would be the bartender. That's it for me, Sonny. I'll see you later. The cabbie says, Right this way, buddy boy. And don't fall down. Phew, man. Is this boy in a bad shape? Yeah, he is. There we go. I'm sorry to have to tell you this, Sonny, says Keith, But I have some bad news for you. Bad news. Cliffhanger time! Ha ha! Lieutenant Morgan sent me over here to advise you that your boy, Sally, has escaped from jail. Oh, goodness. Tiselli jumped a guard, then made it to the exercise yard. We escaped by climbing over the fence. There is a citywide dragnet out on him right now. Morgan wants to see you back in his office ASAP. Or ASAP. I never know quite how to say that. See you later, Sonny. I have business to take care of. And that's it. That's where we'll end episode... English is hard. That's where we'll end the episode. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been Police Quest 1, In Pursuit of the Death Angel. Thank you so much for watching. I hope everyone has an excellent week, and I shall see you soon.